for the headlines. Weather forecast: expect continued warm and humid conditions as a result of the HPA ridge, according to PAGASA. In local news, the city government guarantees water supply even with the extension of COVID. The council approves an immediate alteration to the resolution concerning water supply. Former RTC judge and 7 others die in Kia Revo collision in Cagayan de Oro. The People's Movement will be launched by CAUSA if the COWD COVID issue remains unresolved. Padilla calls on Kiboloy to turn himself in. Chinese Coast Guard follows Philippine vessels conducting research in the West Philippine Sea. International news. Galicia in northern Spain sets new April heat records. Entertainment. Meray Cantiveros cautions against fraudulent PBB auditions and hints at the upcoming season. Dimples Romana clarifies rumors regarding Angel Locsin and Neil Arce. Sports. Thunder secure the top seed in the West, while the Lakers are one win away from reaching the NBA playoffs. In the PBA, Ginebra pulls ahead in the final stretch, defeating Northport for their second consecutive victory. International feature. Italy's Roberto Cavalli, renowned for his mastery of leopard print, passes away at the age of 83. National feature. Is this 13-year-old girl a potential future saint from the Philippines? Trivia. Who is recognized as the inventor of the telephone? Good morning, Philippines! Magandang umaga, Luzon, at mayo adlaw, Visayas, Mindanao. Today is Wednesday, April 17, 2024. I am Athalia P. Sanyel. Weather forecast. Expect continued warm and humid conditions as a result of the HPA ridge, according to PAGASA. A wide area of the Philippines is expected to continue experiencing warm and humid weather due to a high-pressure area ridge. According to PAGASA weather specialist Veronica Torres, when the HPA ridge affects specific areas like the eastern portions of northern and central Luzon, the likelihood of rainfall decreases. Meanwhile, PAGASA also mentioned that trough of a low-pressure area could bring scattered rain showers to parts of Mindanao. Cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms are anticipated in Davao Oriental, Davao de Oro, Davao Occidental, and Sarangani due to the LPA trough. Elsewhere in the country, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms are expected due to localized thunderstorms. PAGASA issued warnings against rain-induced flash floods or landslides in affected areas and advised that light to moderate winds and slight to moderate waters may prevail over the country's seaboards. In Metro Manila, temperatures reached a high of 35.1 degrees Celsius at 2 p.m. Local news. The city government guarantees water supply even with the extension of COVID. Cagayan de Oro City Mayor Rolando Clarix Uy has assured residents that water services will continue without interruption, despite a critical April 12 deadline set by the city's water supplier. Following negotiations over the COWD COVID issue, the city's water supplier Cagayan de Oro Bulk Water Incorporation agreed to extend the disconnection deadline by 30 days to May 13, 2024. This agreement, reached after discussions between COWD and COBE, reflects proactive steps taken by the city of secure its water supply and reduce dependency on COBE. Mayor Uy, alongside the City Council, has taken decisive action to protect water utility services and ensure stability in water supply, including endorsing Rio Verde Water Consortium Incorporation. The Council's strategic decision demonstrates the city's commitment to resolving the water crisis and prioritizing the well-being of its residents. The council approves an immediate alteration to the resolution concerning water supply. The Cagayan de Oro City Council passed an amended resolution, Resolution Number 2024-709, impacting the water supply agreement with Rio Verde Water Consortium Incorporation. This amendment, approved with 14 in favor and 3 against, removes the fixed pricing scheme initially set for Rio Verde. The urgency of the matter, certified as urgent by City Mayor Orlando Clarix Uy, stems from ongoing to conflict between COWD and COBE, aiming to ensure uninterrupted water service for residents amidst potential disruptions from COBE. The resolution underscores the city's commitment to collaborating with alternative water suppliers like Rio Verde to secure a reliable water supply and address the water crisis effectively. The collaborative efforts of the mayor and the city council demonstrate their dedication to residents' best interests, emphasizing transparency and accountability in governance. Councilor Edgardo Cabanlas clarified that the resolution facilitates water supply but is separate from legal issues with COBE, aiming to expedite Rio Verde's operations to supply water to the city without delay. Former RTC judge and 7 others die in Kia Revo collision in Cagayan de Oro. The police will continue the investigation into the fatal collision between a Kia Sorento and a Toyota Revo, resulting in the death of a retired court judge and injuries to 7 members of a family from Barangay Lumbia in the city. The deceased victim was identified as retired RTC Judge Gael Padiranga Jr., 72, residing in Smart Condominium, Upper Carmen. The driver of the Toyota Revo, Joshua De Quina, 46, residing in the Barangay Mambuaya, was also identified. According to the initial police investigation, it is believed that the former judge suffered a medical emergency while driving, causing the Revo to collide with his vehicle. Padiranga was rushed to GR Borja Hospital but was pronounced dead on arrival, while De Quina and his companions were taken to the Northern Mindanao Medical Center for treatment. However, there is no serious condition reported on De Quina's side, except for a child who sustained a foot injury yesterday morning. The People's Movement will be launched by Causa if the COWD COBE issue remains unresolved. The city government's leadership will face a united People's Movement if the financial dispute between Cagayan de Oro Water District and Cagayan de Oro Bulk Water Incorporated remains unresolved. This comes after COWD and COBE continue to incur losses due to the disagreement over the increased water rates outlined in their signed contract. Mindanao Labor Union President Attorney Proculo Sarmen stated that if both the City Hall and the Local Water Utilities Administration fail to address the issue, the Community Alliance of Water Security Action will also take action. Last week, Rio Verde's owner visited the City Hall and assured City Mayor Rolando Clarix Uy that the water supply from COBE will not be halted despite another deadline set for water cutoff on April 30th. We went to the paint store and interviewed them, so let's watch this.
I'm just Toto Alisin. So, AGK Paint Center sa Carmen. Bali, 2 brands kami. Ang isa buong paint center. So, nag-start kami sa business after mga 2017 before. Please, ang among production, kanyang ansal o kanyang buisin o ang Davis Company. Muni siya nag-produce sa mga nagtabang. At least karon mga 5 years na may karong me. So, na may employer, bali, tini sila mga employer. So, maybe continue ragi ako ng production sa pinamo mga pichinter o pan sa mga pasawa, mga trabante. So, kasagaran gina mo dire, karon na prove gina mo katong at least kubi, nakaagig yapon niyo kamay o failure, pero at least nakarecover na yapon. Pero katong sa kubi, mura losing kami ato sa income namo, kaya please, continue man ang rin sa kuan sa building. O rin kami nga rin gyapon at least mga pagwala na sa COVID, naka recover kami gyapon at least karon. Ah, kuan gyapon naka continue gyapon siya. Nai-contact na mo pero at least dili may makasulod sa subdivision mga ini delivery na. So isud gi kaayos tanan. Katunga tayo. Karon maron pa mi naka pag almost nga wala na yung COVID, naka-recover mi. Ano production na mo? At least, tirawagan ka po sa Buisin Company o sa Divis.
So, ano yung supplier sa ka na lang doon ka?
O kang renor siya. O ka, bali, lima siya. Sa production na mo, dalang. Napayahila na mga production niya po. Six production ni siya na siya company na gidala na mo. O, nata yung lawyer na price, nasa sa premium, nasa sa lawyer. Pero depende naman ko sa budget sa tagiya kung mag at least kung mag paripin sa balay niya o renovation libre gyud po mi nag-estimate niya og balay og tanan nga kan libre estimate na sa EGK Paint Center o sa Abong Paint Center sa Carmen Baminta bulibad
sa timplado sa kamutamo lang yapon
sa timpla na mo nami masin sa Buisin o sa Davis. O nami masin og man nami manual gyapon ini color tanan nga mo gina mix tanan nga color sakyanan carpins o ganang ini karta na namo ginamik nasa with machine gyapon
may ang sakyan na di balay mo itong kon sa karon wala kay plano magbuhat og ani kon sa sakyan
na nami siap gyapon nga mga ako mga friend sa Eagles na ako'y ginapasaan gyapon mga customer sa mga atir sa siap, mga kasyo, nami sa siap nga customer nga gina sa insurance siap po, namo na lang ginapasaan. Patong gusto nga magpa-renov, pa-repin sa sakyanan, nagyapon may mga mayo mang tira, nagyapon sa mga sakyanan o mga nato. Kasagaran, kung was over siya, na 30,000, depende sa damage. Pero kung medyo naku-naku ginadamage, na sa 100, na 50, kung mga bangga na sa insurance, na sa body cover.
Pero pa ng goal, kini sa
kasagaran yun sa all, depende sa unit, na 30,000, na 15,000, nasa ay 40. Katong hayin nga sa kinan, may malmal ka siya, siya tayo lang. So, mga, kana siya, medyo si 660, 40 na siya kay masin. Nagya po yung may motor, na repin sa motor, na may pintor na kuwanya po nire, na nagkakuwanya po sa motor. So, panawagan ako sa mga suki, sa mga kontaktor. At least kung nakadarikyan po nire sa mga tinta sa store na mo, kami price ka barato kayo sa na mag-list na gata ng English. Tanang-tanang, barato kayo sa na mga presyo. Hindi sa EGKP Center sa kanya.
Sa kapindahan sa asa
located? Dito sa Kaisano, located sa Kaisano, front sa one, sa baggage na siya. O, Kaisano, diri sa Mercado, front lang siya sa Kaisano. Sa baggage na siya. Ang alam niya na Buong Pin Center, ang manager dito, Buong sa Akyabit. Thank you sa mga join sa customer sa itong kwan. Hello mga friends, customer o kakuya. Facebook na ko kay janbadisin.com 015.com email sa EGK Paint Center.
National News, Padilla calls on Quiboloy to turn himself in. Senator Robin Padilla called on Pastor Apollo Quiboloy to surrender after arrest warrants were issued against the leader of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ, sect Quiboloy, and several others face charges of human trafficking, sexual abuse, and child abuse. Padilla, who previously attended a rally in support of Quiboloy, emphasized the importance of Quiboloy appearing in court and urged his supporters to remain peaceful. Padilla also called for due process amidst calls to revoke Quiboloy's firearms license and stated that while he believes Quiboloy is facing political persecution, he wants the case to be heard in court without political influence. Quiboloy and Padilla are both supporters of former President Rodrigo Duterte. Padilla mentioned that there's no set hearing yet on the revocation of the franchise of the Quiboloy-linked SMNI. Chinese Coast Guard follows Philippine vessels conducting research in the West Philippine Sea. Philippine officials revealed on Monday that the China Coast Guard has been closely monitoring the National Mapping and Resource Information Authority, vessel BRP hydrographer Ventura, and its Philippine Coast Guard escort BRP Gabriela Silang in the West Philippine Sea. According to Coast Guard Commodore J. Tariela, the Chinese vessel has been trailing the Ventura and the Silang, which have been engaged in a week-long hydrographic survey in the northwestern Luzon area. Tariela dismissed China's claims for only deploying vessels in areas not honored by a supposed agreement between former President Rodrigo Duterte and Chinese President Xi Jinping. He emphasized the Philippines' right to conduct research within its exclusive economic zone as ruled by the 2016 Arbitral Award. Retired U.S. Air Force Colonel Ray Powell also reported the presence of a Chinese Coast Guard vessel near Luzon's coastline, shadowing the Philippine vessels until Monday. Jonathan Malaya, spokesperson of the National Security Council, clarified that the Chinese vessel has not blocked the Philippine vessels and that there have been no incidents. Meanwhile, Tariela noted the presence of Filipino fishing boats near Bajo de Masinloc, stating that both Filipino and Chinese fishing vessels are operating in the area without harassment. Malaya confirmed that Filipino fishermen are currently fishing in the vicinity of Bajo de Masinloc without interference. International news. Galicia in northern Spain sets new April heat records. Parts of Galicia in northern Spain and the Canary Islands saw unprecedented heat on Friday, April 12, due to warm air masses from Africa. Spain's weather agency, AEMET, reported temperatures up to 15 degrees Celsius higher than normal for April in some areas. Vigo Airport recorded over 30 degrees Celsius for the first time in April, while Tenerife South Airport broke its April record by 2.1 degrees Celsius. Galician cities like Orense and Lero also experienced record-breaking temperatures on Friday. AMET spokesperson Rubel Del Campo attributed the frequent heat records to stronger and more frequent warm air masses, making the first trimester of 2024 the hottest on record in Spain since 1961. Entertainment. Melay Cantiveros cautions against fraudulent PBB auditions and hints at the upcoming season. Former Pinoy Big Brother winner Melay Cantiveros cautions aspiring PBB housemates to watch out for fake auditions. She emphasized the importance of attending auditions organized solely by the official PBB team, as they are the only ones responsible for selecting housemates. Cantiveros also teased the upcoming reopening of Kuya's house in June will be an exciting season. Additionally, she advised aspiring housemates to audition with sincerity and passion, highlighting the importance of enjoying what they do. Cantiveros also announced her return with Jenica Garcia to give away prizes every night on Primetime Bayan Season 2. Reflecting on her confidence after the reality show, Cantiveros expressed gratitude and contentment, especially now as a mother. She shared a humorous anecdote about declining offers to fix her teeth, expressing satisfaction with her appearance and newfound ability to eat properly. Dimples Romana clarifies rumors regarding Angel Locsin and Neil Arce. Actress Dimples Romana addressed rumors about her close friend actress Angel Locsin and her husband Neil Arce. Dimples refuted speculations of a breakup between Angel and Neil, affirming that Angel remains happily married and well cared for by Neil. She emphasized that tendency for people to rely too heavily on social media for relationship validation, urging a more balanced perspective. Dimples suggested taking breaks from social media to avoid unnecessary comparisons and frustrations. Regarding Angel's potential return to acting after a hiatus, Dimples expressed excitement and anticipation, noting Angel's strong connection with her fans and her evident happiness in her personal life. Sports. Thunder secure the top seed in the West, while the Lakers are one win away from reaching the NBA playoffs. The Oklahoma City Thunder secure the top seed in the Western Conference, surpassing the defending champions, the Denver Nuggets, in NBA regular season's final stretch on Sunday. The Thunder defeated the Dallas Mavericks 135-86, while the Nuggets secured a victory over the Grizzlies but fell short due to the Thunder's head-to-head record advantage. Meanwhile, the Minnesota Timberwolves lost to the Phoenix Suns, solidifying the Suns' sixth playoff berth. Superstar LeBron James led the Los Angeles Lakers to an 8th place finish in the West with a 124-108 win over the New Orleans Pelicans, showcasing his 112th career triple-double. In the PBA, Ginebra pulls ahead in the final stretch, defeating Northport for their second consecutive victory. Ralph Kuz's late three-pointer broke a tie and propelled Barangay Ginebra to a 95-88 victory over the Northport Batang Pier in the 2024 PBA Philippine Cup held at the Ninoy Aquino Stadium on Sunday. Kuz's crucial shot sparked a 10-3 scoring run in the closing minutes, securing Ginebra's second consecutive win and improving their conference record to 5-3. Meanwhile, the Batang Pier fell to a 4-3 win-loss record. Ku earned Player of the Game honors with an impressive near-triple-double performance of 24 points, 10 rebounds, and 9 assists, while Christian Stan Hardinger contributed 25 points and 17 rebounds. Despite a close game with 9 ties and 12 lead changes, Ku's decisive three-pointer ultimately sealed the win for Ginebra. Northport's Arvin Tolentino led his team with 19 points and 9 rebounds. International feature. Italy's Roberto Cavalli, renowned for his mastery of leopard print, passes away at the age of 83. Renowned Italian fashion designer Roberto Cavalli, celebrated for his bold use of animal prints and luxurious designs, passed away at the age of 83, announced the luxury company. From humble beginnings in Florence, Cavalli rose to international fame with his daring styles embraced by celebrities like Sophia Loren and Jennifer Lopez. Despite facing challenges, including a dry spell in the 1980s and legal battles, Cavalli remained an iconic figure in the fashion world. Known for his extravagant lifestyle and love for animal prints, Cavalli's legacy continues to inspire. National feature. Is this 13-year-old girl a potential future saint from the Philippines? The process for the potential canonization of 13-year-old Filipino girl Nina Ruiz Abad, who passed away in 1993, has officially commenced with the Diocesan phase. If declared a saint, she could become the Philippines' third Filipino saint and one of the youngest saints in history. The ceremony held at St. William the Hermit Cathedral in Lawag City marked the beginning of the diocesan investigation into Abad's life and virtues. Following this phase, the documents will be submitted to the dicastery for the causes of saints for further examination. Abad's exemplary piety and devotion to God and the Blessed Virgin Mary have garnered attention, with Bishop Renato Mayuba highlighting her potential as a model of piety and fortitude for the youth. Trivia. Who is recognized as the inventor of the telephone? Alexander Graham Bell is commonly recognized as the inventor of the telephone due to his successful patent and demonstrations of a device capable of transmitting vocal sounds telegraphically. However, the invention of the telephone remains shrouded in controversy and intrigue. While Bell's design was the first patent, there are claims that Alicia Gray, a professor at Oberlin College, also applied for a telephone patent on the same day. Bell's lawyer submitted the application before Gray's, leading to Bell receiving the first patent. Despite this, some historians suggest possible malfeasance at the patent office, sparking ongoing debate about the true origins of the telephone. And that was the information we got from here and abroad. Keep listening and watching. Please subscribe, follow, like, and share Pinoy Rob on YouTube channel. And thank you very much for watching Pinoy Rob News Channel Cagayan de Oro. I am asking once more to support and subscribe and turn on notification for more updates and more info. I repeat, thank you very much and have a wonderful day.